Alvarez versus Gennady Golovkin, part two. Let's talk about the fight. Well, the first thing I want to say is this fight didn't work out the way that I expected it to. It didn't work out that way at all. This is not what I expected to see from Canelo.
Nope.
This is not what I expected to see from Golovkin.
Nope.
And this fight was so much closer than I anticipated. What I can say about the fight is I thoroughly enjoyed it. It was a real nail biter. The fight itself and the aesthetic of the fight, it delivered in all the ways that the first fight didn't. The first fight was a more careful fight. You felt like these guys could be mixing it up a little more, that guys could stand to be throwing a lot more punches, whereas in this fight, you can honestly say that both of them, both Canelo, both Golovkin, they gave it a spirited effort. So as far as the entertainment value of the fight was very entertaining. But we all know that there's a lot of mixed reviews when it comes to this fight. Not necessarily on whether or not people enjoyed it, but how was the fight scored?
Here we go.
Let's get down to brass tacks. Was this fight a robbery? Did Gennady Golovkin get robbed not once, but twice against Canelo Alvarez?
Here we go.
For those of you that are watching this video that don't already know, I thought that Golovkin was not only going to win this fight, but I thought he was going to win this fight by way of knockout or technical knockout late into the fight. I thought that all the different things that have happened between the first fight and now, those things were going to catch up to Canelo Alvarez, that his physical condition, it wouldn't hold up against Golovkin. And what we saw was to the contrary. Canelo Alvarez fought nothing like he did in the first fight. If you're going to be objective and you're going to be unbiased, then you have to acknowledge that the Canelo from the first fight is not the one that Gennady Golovkin was fighting last night. The approach, the implementation, and his demeanor was very different. I'll tell you that the aesthetic of this fight was not what I expected at all. You understand? I didn't expect that Canelo Alvarez was going to be as game and aggressive as he was. I didn't expect it, and I don't think Golovkin and Abel Sanchez did either. I think that this made things difficult for them, that Golovkin looked labored. It was a labored effort on the end of Gennady Golovkin. But he was still hanging in there, you understand? Nobody, you know, this was not a one-sided affair by any stretch of the imagination. This was very much a tit-for-tat, even kind of fight to where certain rounds are very difficult to score. And depending on who you give those rounds, that's what's going to have the biggest impact on the fight. This was a fight that, by my count, had at least three, at minimum. It had three swing rounds.
Maybe more.
But at the end of the fight, once the final bell rung, I looked at my scorecard, and I had it 7-5. For Gennady Golovkin. 7-5, but I wasn't sure. I wasn't certain that he really did enough. I only had him up by one round. And with that, the fight is far too close. It's far too close when you're fighting Canelo Alvarez.
Wink, wink.
And we'll talk further about what I mean by saying that.
Yeah, no.
That if it's 7-5, if I've got it 7-5, and I count that there are still three swing rounds, there's still, you know, one of these rounds that I might have gave to Golovkin, they might have went to Canelo. You never know. It's a close fight. It's hard to score.
Close fight.
So in that way,
when it's close,
even though I had it 7-5 for Triple G, I can't call it a robbery. This fight, you could argue, is really a draw. You could argue that this fight is an even draw between both of these guys. You could argue that because the fight was that close. But when the judges announced their decision, I didn't find myself objecting it the way I did their decision in the first fight. In the first fight, when I heard that that fight was a draw, I immediately thought, that's bullshit. This fight was not a draw. That's not what I saw. Whereas in this fight, when the judges announced their scorecard, I didn't find myself objecting to that decision, and that's because of how close this fight was. That's because of how much Canelo took us all by surprise. He took me by surprise by coming forward as much as he did, by being as aggressive as he was, and by weathering the kind of punches that he weathered. That's not what I expected. I expected Canelo Alvarez to go out on his shield, and he didn't go out on his shield. I expected him to be in haphazard condition by the time the mid-rounds rolled around, and that simply wasn't the case. The Canelo that we saw here
was very aggressive.
Was giving Gennady Golovkin all the opportunities that he deprived him of in the first fight. And that allows me to allude to my point. For all the Golovkin people out there that are feeling jilted and disenfranchised by the sport of boxing, feeling that Golovkin was robbed not only once but twice, for those of you guys that are out there, you have to ask yourselves a question. If you truly feel that Gennady Golovkin won a decisive victory in the first fight, if you feel he was robbed in the first fight in spite of putting on a better performance than what we saw last night,
which was close,
if you feel that he won that fight and all they gave him was a draw, then what's going to happen in a rematch when the rematch is far closer? When in the rematch, Canelo Alvarez is not circling away from Gennady Golovkin, rather he's coming towards him, where the fight is mostly fought in the center of the ring, where not only does Gennady Golovkin draw blood, but so does Canelo. Where both fighters, not just Golovkin, not like the first fight, not like where Golovkin is the guy who's pressing forward and pressing the action and throwing all the punches, not like the first fight, in a rematch, where both of these guys are going for it, they're both putting forth the same effort, what do you think happens in a rematch when it's closer than the first fight? If you believe that Golovkin won the first fight and he was robbed,
gave him a draw,
then what happens in a rematch when it's closer?
Think about it.
When it's kind of right down the middle, what are you expecting to happen?
Fairness.
What are you expecting the judges to do?
Be fair.
You know, as a boxing fan, if you've been a boxing fan long enough, you become very cynical, especially in these kinds of situations. You take in the full gravity of what's going on here, that Gennady Golovkin is fighting the only pay-per-view attraction this side of the Atlantic. You're fighting a pay-per-view star, a marquee fighter, on the biggest stage you could be fighting on, the biggest stage you've ever fought in your career. You tend to be cynical in those situations because you realize that you have to go above and beyond what you might think is enough to win the fight. And you have to go above and beyond what your fans might think is enough to win the fight. Essentially, if you guys didn't think that Gennady Golovkin got a fair shake in the first fight, right? You guys think he got robbed. And that was a more decisive victory than this one.
This was close.
If you guys think he got robbed in a fight where he had a more decisive victory, what happens in the rematch when the rematch is closer?
Canelo wins.
When the rematch is almost right down the middle. When you could make an argument that Canelo might have just been up a round. You have to factor in a margin of error. Not just for yourself, but for the judges.
What they see.
There may be a margin of error. There may be swing rounds.
Several.
These rounds may be very difficult to score and you don't know who's really getting them. If there is one or two or three or more swing rounds, that can have a big impact on how the fight is being scored. And while you might have it one way on your scorecard, there may be a margin of error on your scorecard. In turn, there may be a margin of error on the judges' scorecards. It can be any variety of things like that in a fight this close.
Too close.
But reality sets in and you realize Gennady Golovkin is fighting a pay-per-view attraction in what is a very close fight.
Okay.
So if it does go to the cards, what do you think is going to happen?
When it's close.
You guys sitting at home, us fans, the guys out there that felt that Gennady Golovkin was going to win the fight, be honest with yourself.
I am.
You had Golovkin winning by knockout or technical knockout the same way I did.
Didn't you?
But if I would have told you before the fight that this thing is going to go to the cards and when it does, this will have been a very close fight.
What happens?
If I would have told you that the fight is close and it's going to go to the cards, who do you think the judges would have given it to?
Golovkin?
Who do you think they're going to give the decision if it goes to a decision? You know, before the first fight, everybody was saying it. If this thing goes to the cards could come back funny. And to most of us, including me, they did.
In the first fight.
I felt Golovkin won the first fight. I still do. I think he was robbed. But in a fight, in a fight that is this close, with this kind of an opponent, a marquee fighter, what are you expecting to happen when Golovkin doesn't make a conscious effort to go to the body, to tire Canelo out early, make a conscious effort to go to his body so when the mid rounds roll up, he's already tired. And by the time the late rounds roll around, he's got nothing left.
Finish him.
What do you know, that's one of the things that I noticed, that Golovkin, even in this rematch, with everything that's on the line, with everything that he's sacrificed and everything that he's been through to get Canelo in the ring one more time, with all these things in mind, he still didn't make a conscientious effort to go to the body. Take away Canelo's legs, target his stamina. So by the time the eighth and the ninth roll around,
he's finished.
This guy's getting beaten from post to post. Tax his stamina. Golovkin didn't do that.
He headhunted.
I see a lot of people arguing right now, making the same arguments about the rematch that they made about the first fight. That, you know, Golovkin landed plenty of jabs. Yeah, and he landed plenty of jabs in the first fight. That didn't win him the decision, did it? No, it didn't. And here we are in a rematch, which was closer than the first fight, and you're still arguing about the jabs? Come on, guys. You gotta grow up.
Realize something.
I'm not telling you to be Canelo Alvarez fans. I'm certainly not. He didn't make a fan out of me with this fight, if that's what you're thinking.
No way.
I'm not telling you guys to be fans of that guy. I'm telling you that this fight was much closer than the first. and it's for that reason that you really can't call it a robbery. I still consider the first fight a robbery, but this fight was much closer than that fight. And in a fight this close, with these two kinds of opponents, you can't go screaming robbery. That's simply not the case.
It was a close fight.
But you know what? For argument's sake, I'll go a step further. Supposing it was a robbery. Supposing they took a round from Golovkin that really should have went to him. Supposing they took one of, you know, a round, they gave it to Canelo. Just for good measure. So, to, you know, to make sure that if it does go to the cards, Canelo's got at least one round in the bag, working for him. Supposing that's the case, hypothetically speaking.
Hypothetically.
Weren't we all saying that Golovkin needs a knockout? Not just in the rematch, but in the first fight. I mean, we were all saying this. That Golovkin needs a knockout. Some of us were banking on a knockout. I was banking on a knockout or a technical knockout. Because that was the only conceivable way that Golovkin would be a shoe-in to win the fight. That you know, I mean, he needed a knockout.
Otherwise...
And we've been saying this for a while now.
He'd get robbed.
So when you see that the fight was close, the rematch, that is, when you see it was close and you see that Golovkin, he still didn't manage to wrap this guy up.
Finish him.
Except now the dynamic of the fight is entirely different. You see Canelo being a pressure guy, where Golovkin is normally the pressure guy. You see Canelo being the pressure guy, and you see Golovkin
being pressured,
using the boxing, using the pivots, using the angles, tucking in his chin, rolling punches off his shoulder. Golovkin pulled out all the stops. If we talk about what these guys did in their efforts, it was a fantastic fight. I saw some great boxing from Canelo Alvarez, saw some great boxing from Gennady Golovkin. But if you see that the fight is close, and you've been telling yourself that Golovkin needs a knockout, otherwise something, you know, it might go wrong.
Don't let it happen.
Then don't act surprised. Don't act surprised about a decision like this one in a fight that's this close. You see, I think a lot of you will agree with me when I say that I feel that Gennady Golovkin was robbed in the first fight. And the best way to characterize the rematch, and the best analogy for the rematch, is it's like having a crackhead uncle or a crackhead cousin. It's like leaving your money on top of your dresser, in your room, with the door open, and you got a crackhead cousin or a crackhead uncle or whatever. And then the money comes up missing, and you know that your cousin or your uncle's a crackhead.
They'll rob you.
And the money comes up missing.
If you let them.
You know that the best thing for you to do is to close that door. Put that money somewhere else.
Don't give them a chance to take it.
Well, that kind of applies here. That if you leave the door open for Canelo to make the fight competitive, if you don't go out there and you don't finish him and the fight is competitive, you left the door open for what you and your fans might call a robbery. Because you've already been here once before. Remember, you are the guys that don't feel that you got a fair shake in the first fight. So what, you were expecting to get a fair shake in the second one? Against the guy who the sanctioning bodies were already labeling as innocent before they concluded their investigations? Against the guy who had two positive tests showing that he had performance-enhancing drugs in his system? And yet somehow, he's still able to participate in the rematch in a timely fashion. You're expecting to get a fair shake against this guy, the guy who you feel robbed you in the first fight. The intention should have been kill or be killed. And I didn't see Golovkin take chances. I didn't. I didn't see him take the chances that he would have needed to take to really hurt Canelo. When Canelo applied pressure, Golovkin
chose to box him.
Resorted to boxing him. In the first fight, you say that he didn't want to fight. He spent it circling away. He wasn't giving you the chance to engage, yada, yada, yada. Well, he gave you that chance in this fight. And when he did, when he started applying pressure, you turned into the boxer. You turned into the boxer when that was your opportunity to turn into the killer, the boogeyman. So understand when I say that I'm very cynical in this situation.
Gotta take risks.
That even though, by the end of the fight, I had it 7-5 for Gennady Golovkin, understand that 7-5 for Gennady Golovkin might be far too close against Canelo. No, you can't get a 7-5 with Canelo. You've got to get a 9-3. A 9-3 or an 8-4, and that'll get you a draw. And if you want to skip this process altogether, if you're struggling to understand it, here's the thing. Go in there, knock the fucker out, and you won't even have to worry about it. And that's just it. Golovkin didn't get the knockout. We all knew that his safest bet to win this fight, the only way that he can stop them from taking it from him, if that's what you think happened, the only way he can stop them is to knock Canelo out. And he didn't. Oh, we can sit here and argue about punch stats and who landed the better punches in the round and the whole song and dance from last year. We can do all that all over again. Or what we can say is, hey, how many guys actually thought Golovkin could win a decision.
Not me.
How many guys that had Golovkin winning had him winning a points decision?
Not me.
Because I had him winning by way of knockout because that was the only conceivable way he could win. That was the only way I felt that he could secure the victory. And guess what? It went to the cards, and the fight was far closer than I expected. So you'll excuse me if I'm not one of these guys that's screaming robbery. He knew what he was getting into, and so did we.